afternoon, Para Wesley music lovers. It's good to have you with us. This is a pre-recorded program this afternoon. I hope I don't look too much as if I should actually still be asleep, but that might be true. But yes, we say thank you to Derek for putting together the program. I won't be able to greet people on the sidebars because this is pre-recorded, but let's give Derek an opportunity to say hello.
Hi everybody, I hope you enjoy our concert today. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Derek. And today's program is a program of hymns, so feel free to sing along. The first one that we have is The Church's One Foundation, which has South African roots, perhaps not the best roots, but in the mid-19th century, Bishop John William Colenso of Natal raised a ruckus in the Catholic Church when he challenged the historicity and authority of many Old Testament books. Bishop Gray of Cape Town wrote a stirring response of defense, which in 1866 inspired Samuel Stone to write this beloved hymn, basing his text on Article 9 of the Apostles' Creed, "The Holy Catholic Church, the Communion of Saints, he is the head of this body." Now it's an affirmation of Christ as the foundation of our faith. We sing this hymn with those who have gone before us and with Christians around the world, declaring that beyond any theological differences, cultural divides, and variances in practice, we are all part of the same body, the body of Christ. That little blurb comes from hymnary.org. And the tune that Derek is playing is known as Aurelia, meaning golden, was composed by Samuel Sebastian Wesley, the grandson of Charles Wesley. So thank you, Derek. Let's listen to this, the hymn. Thank you for that, Derek. I think one of our favorite hymns, it does remind us of how central Jesus is to all that we believe and do. Next one, Up His Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven. Derek plays the tune Regent Square. It's not the tune that I'm used to. It's funny how from different parts of the country we may grow up with different tunes to the hymns. But this tune is called Regent Square. It's named that because the first book it was published in was edited by the minister of Regent Square Presbyterian Church. And so he had this new tune and he just gave it the name Regent Square. And we spoke last time about the meter of tunes. This meter is 878787, which is a meter that is found very often amongst hymns. And so it was originally written for a doxology hymn. It starts with Glory be to God the Father. And also the other hymn that is often sung to this tune is Angels from the Realms of Glory. So as Derek plays, you can sing along to Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven, or you can sing to Angels from the Realms of Glory. If you happen to know the doxology hymn, Glory be to God the Father, you may try and fit those words to it as well. But let us, in whatever way we choose, worship God as we listen to Derek playing. Thank you, Derek, for that. I really feel like I'm speaking from a dark dungeon this morning as I record. It's not that dark and it's not that dungeonous. It's just that the sun is still trying to get its way up. Thank you, Derek, for playing for us. And the next one up, Derek also plays the second tune for this hymn, second set tune, O Worship the Lord in the Beauty of Holiness. This tune is called Sanctissimus and was written by William H. Cook, of whom I can find no information. It seems that sometimes the authors of hymns are people that write the hymns with just because they want to write the hymns and they don't try to publish them or be associated with them in any particular way. The words were written by John Monsell, who was born in Ireland in 1811, and he was a prolific poet, and his poetry was published in 11 volumes. He wrote over 300 hymns. We worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Thank you, Derek, for reminding us about beauty of holiness and of worshiping God as we try to live our lives as we ought to live. Next up is And Can It Be, a hymn that doesn't really need any further introduction, but one that we do like to sing out. Words by Charles Wesley, the tune is called Sojourner, written by Thomas Campbell. Again, we know very little about Thomas Campbell, except that he named his tunes after plants. And so the Sojourner is a sort of carnation, or the genus of the carnation. And so we sing And Can It Be to the tune Carnation. Thank you, Derek, for a stirring hymn. The next one can also be quite stirring. And How Sweet the Name of Jesus Sounds. The tune is called St. Peter, this time named after St. Peter's Church, written by Alexander, now I don't know how to pronounce this, I found so many different pronunciations. He was born in Austria, and so probably his name should be pronounced Reinachel. But because he lived in England, it may have become pronounced Reinagle. So let's talk about Alexander Reinagle, and if anybody knows any better, they can please let me know. He didn't originally write this tune for this hymn, but it seemed to fit these words better and is now usually associated with it. The words are How Sweet the Name of Jesus Sounds were written by John Newton, who also wrote Amazing Grace. He had an eventful life, spending some time as a slave trader before he became a Christian. So let's listen and sing along to How Sweet the Name of Jesus Sounds in a Believer's Ear. Thank you for that, Derek. And now we come to the last piece for our program today. Derek has played what we would think of as a chorus or a praise and worship song, perhaps, but from the 1960s when they tended to be called choruses. One of the many anonymous songs that came out of the charismatic movement of the 1960s. I think very easy songs to sing, very easy songs to write, and I think they just used to develop as people sang together. It is based on Philippians chapter 2, verse 10 to 11. So at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. And we know it as He is Lord. So thank you, Derek. So we come to the end of the program for today. I hope that you enjoyed it. Thank you to Derek for playing for us. Thank you to all those who have tuned in either now as it plays at 12 o'clock or later on watching in your own time. Good to have you as part of the Para Wesley family. Good that we can join together and do this quite safely without going out into that COVID world. So wishing you all a very good rest of the week and may God bless you. Music.